In this lecture of transformer, we are going to discuss about the ideal transformer. The ideal transformer is the imaginary transformer which is not only free of all type of losses but also has an efficiency of 100%. It is the transformer which has no core loss, ohmic resistance loss or no leakage flux. So the efficiency of this transformer is 100%. It is only consists of two purely inductive coils and inductive coils wounded on a core which is considered to be loss free. And in the case of an ideal transformer, it gives the output power exactly to the input power. Now, let's see some characteristics of the ideal transformer. The first characteristics of the ideal transformer is the zero winding resistance. The resistance of the primary as well as the resistance of the secondary of winding of an ideal transformer is zero. That is, both the coils are purely inductive in nature and has no resistive value. The second characteristics of the ideal transformer is the infinite permeability of the core. Infinite core permeability is a theoretical concept that refers to a magnetic core that has no resistance to the flow of magnetic flux. It is a theoretical property of a magnetic core that allows the perfect coupling between the primary and secondary windings of a transformer. In reality, no material has infinite core permeability. However, some materials such as iron and steel have very high permeabilities. This means that they can provide a very close approximation to the core permeability in some application. Now, we know that reluctance R is equal to L by mu into A. If the permeability mu tends to infinity, then the reluctance R tends to zero. For a core, this L and A, which are the length of the magnetic circuit and cross-sectional area of the magnetic circuit. Now, we know that flux into reluctance equal to number of turns into current flow. And if we put the value of reluctance as L divided by mu into A, then the equation will become flux phi into L by mu into A is equal to number of turns into current. And this current flow I can be simplified as phi into L in divided by mu into A. For an ideal transformer, this permeability mu is tends to infinity, so the current I will be equal to zero. So an ideal transformer does not require any current from the supply to set up flux in the core or magnetizing the core under no load condition. Another characteristics of the ideal transformer is the no leakage flux and leakage inductance. Leakage flux is the magnetic flux that does not pass through the core of the transformer. It is caused by imperfect coupling between the primary and secondary windings, and leakage inductance is the inductance of the leakage flux in a transformer. In an ideal transformer, there is no leakage flux or leakage inductance. This means that all of the magnetic flux produced by the primary winding is coupled to the secondary winding. And another characteristics of the ideal transformer is the 100% efficiency. This is because an ideal transformer has no loss. In the ideal transformer, there is no loss due to the resistance in the winding or due to leakage flux, and there will also be no loss due to the hysteresis or eddy current loss in the core. Another characteristics of the ideal transformer is the unity coupling coefficient. This means that all of the magnetic flux produced by the primary winding is coupled to the secondary winding, which in the other words also means that there is no flux linkage. Another characteristic of the ideal transformer is the transformation ratio. Transformation ratio or turn ratio is equal to its secondary to primary terminal voltage and also equal to primary to secondary current, or E1 by E2 is equal to N1 by N2, which is equal to I2 by I1 is equal to K. Another characteristics of the ideal transformer is the constant frequency, which means that the frequency is constant in the case of primary and secondary voltages. Another characteristics of the ideal transformer is the constant phase angle, which means that the phase angle between the output voltage and current is same as the phase angle between the input voltage and current. Last and one of the important characteristics of the ideal transformer is no noise. An ideal transformer does not produce any noise. These are some of the important characteristics of an ideal transformer. In the next lecture, we will see the phasor diagram of an ideal transformer at no load condition. This concludes our discussion for this lecture. In the event that you have any question regarding this presentation, feel free to post them in the comment section and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.